Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. In today's lesson, we are going to deep dive into creating a model-driven app using Microsoft Power Apps connected to Dataverse. In the previous video, we created a table called Product inside the solution. If you want to follow the entire series of videos, just go back to the previous video. Before we begin, it's important to understand that a model-driven app is based on the data model, which means we have a more structured approach to create the app. We create the data model, then we create the model-driven app, as the name says, connecting to this data model. Usually, I create all the tables before creating the model-driven app, but I like to use this approach to teach where I create the first table, then we go and create the app to understand how things are connected. There are also two very important concepts that are the views and the forms, and we are going to cover this on this video. Right, since I have my table already created, I'm going to create a model-driven app to connect to this table and also for the other tables that we're going to create in the next videos. I'm already inside the solution. As we did in the last class, we created a solution called commercial system and created a table inside it. Now I'm going to go to new and create an app. So we have app and we have three options: the canvas app, model driven app, and page. We are going to cover all of them, but now we are going to create a model driven app. Once I click here, I will go to the new model driven app page. Now let's give our app a name and a description, and that will help the users understand its purpose. So the name will be Commercial System, same name as I gave to the solution. And the description is helps the internal team to process the sales. Okay, let's click on create and wait for it to load, and then we can start adding pages to it. Pages mean the tables that we want to see, okay? So let's wait a little. After it's loaded, if we hit play, we can publish and continue, but it doesn't let us publish because we don't have any page on it. It's just a blank app, right? Here's the interface, and we can add pages. So once I click on new here in the top, I'm prompted to add these options: a Dataverse table. That's what we are going to do. We are going to connect to a table called product. We could add a dashboard. That's a dashboard created based on a table. We could create a custom page that's basically a canvas app for embedding in model-driven apps. We can add a web resource that could be an HTML. Or also a navigation link, so once I click, it goes to another link. Let's go to Dataverse table, and once I click here, I can find all my tables on my environment. And I know that the table is called products. So I'll select this table and click on add. Now it adds to the navigation, and we also have home, recent, and pinned, but we can disable those. Here is the most important one, that's the product that we just added. It's inside a group called new group. Here in the left, we also have this navigation tree, like the canvas app, where we can see all our pages. And here we see that we have the products view and products form. That's something I mentioned a couple of seconds ago. I can already play this app to see what's the result. So we hit publish, it will save and publish, and then we hit play. Notice that so far I didn't do any change here, I didn't have to configure anything. Now it's published, I can hit play. And the model-driven app is already playing. Here I can see my product table, I can click on it and see all the products that I have registered. And I already have some functions here, some actions on the top that I could use. I can create a new to create a new product. We only have the option to add the product name here, But if you have seen the previous video, you know that we have more columns and we need to add those. I'm not going to save right now, let's just go back. And we also know that here we have more columns, but we are just seeing the two columns, that's the name and the created on. So now we can configure in the views and in the forms of the table, we can go back to our data model and configure these options. We can configure the view, that's what's going to show in here, the columns that's showing here, and we can configure the form, that's what happens when we click in a product or any item, if it's another table, that will open the form that allows us to edit or create a new item. So we can add the other columns to the views and to the forms. Okay, that's basically what composes a model driven. We go to the model, configure it, and it already reflects in here. Here, what we need to do is basically to add the tables that we want to see, or add some other customizations such as dashboards, pages, or custom, web resource or navigation link. Okay, so let's go back now to our table to configure in there and see that's going to reflect in here without needing to change anything in the model driven. The model driven app is already published. See, if I go back to our solution, we have the product table, and if I click on it, I'm going to open the table properties and configurations. We have forms and views. I mentioned here, let's go back to the model driven, that this page that displays the items is called view, a view. So let's go back and let's go to views. Here we have several views, but as you can see here in the model driven, it's called active products. This is the name of the view that shows in here. It's a default view that's created once you create a table. So it's called active products. The table is called products. We also have the inactive products. We have two views because we have this concept of activating or deactivating a row. But we are going to see that later. Let's focus on the views. Okay, we have this view that shows here by default called active products. If I go back and click on active products, then I can see the view configuration. And here I see that we have product name and created on. But here in the left, I have several other fields that I can add. For example, description. Is bestseller, that's a column we also created in the previous video. What else? Product codes. Product category. And we also have product image we can add, but it won't show in the view correctly. But let's add all the columns we created previously. We also have other ones that are default columns. They were created already once we create the table by default. We have created by, modified on, and so on. Usually I like to add created by and created on. Only those two default columns, and I add to the very end of the view. Now that I brought all the columns I wanted to the view, I can publish. So I can hit save and publish. Let's wait a little for it to finish publishing. And let's go back to our model-driven app and see the result. Now that's published, I'm going to go back to the app. Notice that I didn't change the app, and now I'm going to refresh the page. It's loading the views information, and soon it's going to show in here. After the first load, it takes more time, but then it's not so slow. So now it has loaded, and see, we can see all the columns here in the view. We didn't need to change the app. If I click in the product, see, we don't see the product image. I don't know if I have an image for this one. We will check later, but I don't think it shows. Let's see. If I click in the name, we see the form and we want to add the columns in here. Let's go back to our table, go back here to exit the view part and go back to the tables, select the table again. And inside it, we have forms. Again, we have three forms. The form that shows in here to edit when we click in the item is called the main form. So if you go back, we see the form type, main right here. All of the forms are called information. I don't know why it should be called main form, card form, and quick view form, but they are all called information. I'm going to click in the first one, that's the main type. Once I click on it, I see the form configuration. And here, again, I have all the columns for that table. I can add the columns I want. So I'm going to add the description, the is best seller, the product category, the product image, and the product codes. The product code I will put right below the product name. Okay. Each column has one data type here. For example, the description is rich text, as we created in the previous video. So it shows as a rich text editor that I can format the text. The is bestseller is a yes or no, the category is a choice. It will render differently. They are going to render differently in the form. I'm going to save and publish. Let's wait for it to publish. And now that's published, we are going to go back to our model-driven app, refresh the page. Notice that I didn't change the model-driven app at all. I just changed the form in the data. That's why it's called model-driven. It's data-driven. So I changed the tables, the configurations in there, and it reflects the app. I changed the model, it changes the app. And here we have all the fields that we added. Now I can edit my beer 02. I can add a description, add an image, and save it. So let's give it a better name now that we have the form to edit. I'm going to call it Samba Sunset Lager. Give it a description that I generated here. And I'll choose a new image. Okay, I also generate an image. File types not supported. Okay, it needs to be on these types. And the image that I have here is another format. What's the format of this? WebP. I'll have to save the image in the correct format. I'll just screenshot it and save it as a PNG. Now it's uploading. Okay, I can just save. It will save the new information. Since this image column is the primary image, it shows right here in the top at the side of the name. Okay, I'll just go to products. And now we see these two beers here that I had previously registered. The product image doesn't show in the view. So we may not want this column here because it's not useful. If I want to remove, what do I need to do? Just go back to the views of the table and remove this column from the view. Let's do this to finish this lesson. So I'm going to go back to the table. Okay, I need to go to the solution, find the table, find the view. So I will go to views, and then we have the active products in there. I click on it and just remove this column from the view. So click on the column and then remove. It won't delete the column from the table, just remove from the view. Then I just save and publish. Once it's published, I can go back to my app, refresh it, and then the column is not there anymore. But if I open the records, I will go to the form that I also added in the table configuration, and I see the image right here. Okay, now we have this model driven complete, and I could add new products. For example, go to new, create a new product and save, and so on. I have just mentioned about the active and inactive items a couple of minutes ago, and in the next video, I'm going to explain this a little bit more. See you in the next video.